Hello, Mr. R. Roger. I'm revising my book on the first Gnostic principles of one God, one faith, and I'm putting them in chapter 17 in small bits, parts, so that you can have easily look at it and enjoy it. So this faithful and unfaithful to God by the descendants of Isaac and Ishmael is further reflected in the stories relating to the sacrifice of Abraham, Ishmael and Abraham-Isaac story. In the Abraham-Ishmael story, there is a mention of the repulsion of Satan by Ishmael, before God presented to them a ram for sacrifice and rejoicing, whereas in the Abraham-Isaac story, there is no mention of the repulsion of Satan, because unlike Ishmael, the people of Isaac, being the Jews of flesh, were already sons of the Satan and not of God. Remember Jacob struggling with angels. Angels are sons of man. So that means he struggled with them and told them, I'm not son of man. I want only the most high God. But you can't have most high God without being son of man. So when they became unfaithful to Abraham, the land became barren and they were thrown out of the land, promised land. Therefore, no ram could be presented to Abraham, Isaac. And this is depicted in the promised land becoming barren. And this is a typical example of the corruption of the holy books analogized by Jesus to the old cloth, the written holy books, developing holes which cannot be patched with the brand new cloth, which is gospel, but they are repairable through the knowledge of gospel. Jesus came to fulfill the law, but not to destroy it. You can darn it, you know. Any holes created in the Old Testament or in the scripture with the knowledge of the New Testament, you can draw them, you can make them complete. But you can't patch the old cloth, the scriptures, with the brand new cloth, gospel. In the Bible, they are patched together, which is wrong. That's why Marcion, he rejected the Old Testament, and they have Judaized the Bible. The key to understand the criterion of faithfulness and unfaithfulness to God lies in the saying, a Jew is one who is inwardly of the spirit and not outwardly of the flesh. Thus, the descendants of Isaac, when they become the Jews of flesh through the circumcision of flesh, the birth of a Jewish woman, you know. Jewish woman who has no seed. A woman doesn't have a seed. Seed lie with the men. So that means they become seedless if they are Jew of the Jewish woman. Then they are unfaithful to Abraham and God, whilst when they become Jews of spirit, through the circumcision of their hearts, that means by learning the real truth, then they become faithful to God. Thomas Logo 53. His laborers said to him, Jesus had no disciple, he had laborers employed in the vineyard of our Father. Is circumcision beneficial or not? He said to them, if it were beneficial, their heavenly Father Yahweh would beget them already circumcised from their mother, from the mother's womb. Rather, this true circumcision in spirit, in God, has become completely profitable. So this is the age of God, and so we need circumcision of the in God, you know. Thus, most of the present Jews of flesh who claim Israel to be the country of Jews, and they normally talk in such terms as the Jewish race, races of the body, you know, not of this inward soul, the Jewish settlements, etc., are the people who are unfaithful to Abraham, whereas the faithful to God, Jews of spirit, always talk in terms of the tribal identity of the flesh. Thus, in the Revelation, the people who will be saved are clearly mentioned in terms of the tribes, the sons of Abraham, and not as the Jews. They are mentioned 12,000 of this tribe, 12,000 and this tribe, 144,000 would be saved. They are all mentioned by tribes. There is a corruption in this one too, but they have corrupted the New Testament as well. It is also worth stressing that the Hajj rites, Hajj which the Mohammedan perform, are in honor of Abraham, who earned the title of Father of the Faithful. That means those Arabs, they were fathers, they are faithful to Abraham. And that's why when Jesus was baby, he was sent into the care of the Egyptian to look after him. And they honored him very much. Father of the faithful, the angels with whom Jacob struggled, for in spirit are the knowledge of God. He said, I know not God, I don't want to know Adam. So that's why he suffered, you know. He was superior to angels, but without being a son of man. Abraham, if he is superior to angels, mean he has given bye-bye to Abraham. But without being a son of Abraham, you cannot be the son of God. This John the Baptist demonstrated by baptizing only the sensible Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham and handing them over this salt of the Abraham sons for Christ Jesus to preach them into the sons of God, which is by grace. So when Jesus picked up the 11, he picked 12, Judas Iscariot said, oh, I am educated, let me join you. So the one he picked, you know, 11, they were all, their names were written in the book of our Father. So they were all predestined. At present, these rites have completely lost their significance. The Hajj rite, you know, they are completely lost their significance and they are producing fanatic. In short, the Hajj is for the entry into the realm or threshold of Islam by accepting the tribal birth that Allah gave to you in a family. Now, you can't take your own birth in a family. Allah gave you the birth in this particular family. So when you identify that family, identify yourself with that tribal family, then you become accepting the will of Allah, that you are becoming faithful to Allah as well. Then you learn to speak secular truth, become contented by understanding His word, and finally show or perform acts of mercy, like the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person, in order to seal your faith and services in Allah. Such a perfect, merciful person is then worthy to be called a Muslim. So Abraham was a Muslim, you know. or they called it Muslim in brief. So anybody, you know, who is a have this quality of mercy, he is a Muslim, even in rest. You know, you don't need to become a member of this, become a Mohammedan, or so-called Islam, which is a mullah, which is of Satan. For such a Muslim, no fasting, prayer, or Hajj. Present Hajj is creating fanatic sons of Satan, Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, the most powerful Satan that moves the mountain of fanatics to crush the tears that but defeated by the tribal sons of man. As my late father turned 2,000 fanatics into our best friends in Allah by explaining to them that a Muslim or a Sikh is a spiritual self, never born and never die. But the tribal selves, we are Jat, you know, and they were Arai, are going to fight and die. So the headman of the attacking party, he understood it, you know. And then my father told him, if there is any enmity between our tribes, then this is the best way, best time to settle. There's no law and order, so we can settle. But there was no enmity between our tribes. They became our best friends in Allah. So Allah only protects those who are tribal people, who are not mentioning their tribe or concealing their tribe. He doesn't want to know them. So that's the importance of Allah. So I will stop here. And our Father God blesses you. And we will do the next one. So here you are. Our Father blesses you.